Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome tonight's MC, Gary Huddleston, Chairman of the Greater Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce and Consumer Affairs Director with Kroger Stores.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our 2015 State of the City Address, produced by your five-star Greater Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce, the only five-star chamber in the state of Texas. Now that you've settled in, I'd like for you to rise and welcome the Irving Police and Fire Honor Guard to present our colors. And also, we are extremely honored to have with us award-winning and Irving native Jazz Sexton, Dallas actress and creative associate at the Irving-based Solo Shoe Communications, and she will perform our national anthem.
Forward march.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, and the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner wave o'er the
Wow, you can understand why Jade's award-winning. I feel like I need to say play ball. Ladies and gentlemen, providing the invocation this evening will be Judge Ed Kincaid. Judge Kincaid serves as a U.S. District Judge for the Northeastern District of Texas, a position he has held since 2002. He is a Baylor University and Baylor Law School graduate, very active in the community, serving on the board of Baylor Scott & White Health System. And one of his latest pet projects is a new canine training center at the Baylor Irving Capel, which will train dogs to be service animals for disabled veterans. Judge Kincaid himself trained his own yellow lab named Bo to be a pet therapy dog. Most importantly, he is a lifelong Irving resident, so please join me in welcoming to the podium Judge Ed Kincaid. Thank you all. Let us pray. Our Father, we thank you for the leadership in our wonderful community. From the time when my family moved here in the 50s, when it was the fastest growing city in the United States, and that fantastic growth, and the 60s when the city had to put up with my brother and I growing up as teenagers, Lord. And I thank you for the leaders helping both of us grow to be leaders today in our respective communities. And Lord, through the 70s when we saw Las Colinas and the Cowboys come here, in the 80s, the 90s, the 2000s, I want to thank each of those eras, folks, Lord, and for you giving to us, those that gave their time, their talents, and when folks were fussing about whether or not they could put the back seat of their car in the street or whatever they were wanting to do, they would be willing to listen. They're willing to be leaders. They're willing to be patient and to give their time. Lord, I just thank you for all that great leadership, for this wonderful night, and for this wonderful opportunity that we have to serve you in the community. Thank you very much, Lord, and bless this evening and bless our wonderful country. In thy name we pray, amen.
Please be seated. It's really my pleasure to be the chairman of the Greater Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce. I'm humbled to be in that position, and it's really nice to see each and every one of you gathered here tonight, and so thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate everybody that's gathered to celebrate this signature program, and it's in its 34th year. Tonight is about enjoying ourselves, friends, fellowship, and celebrating our award-winning 2014 accomplishments in the city of Irving. We want to share the great news about Irving, and be sure and share it with others. And I'd like to ask you, the only time I'd like to see your mobile device is when you're tweeting that you're here this evening, and also on Facebook. Be sure and tag the city of Irving and the chamber. We have a lot to be proud of in our city, and tonight we'll take a moment to recognize the many accomplishments over the past year and hear from Mayor VanDuyne about what we can expect in the year 2015 and beyond. Before we go any further, we're pleased to have with us many elected and appointed officials, and I'd like to acknowledge and thank them for their great work, their dedication to service and to the city of Irving. Please hold your applause while I recognize the city officials and the elected officials that are here tonight. And I just ask for our elected official, just raise your hand so that we can recognize you properly. From the state, Irving state representatives, we have Representative Matt Rinaldi. He's here tonight. Representative Rodney Anderson. From the Irving City Council, we have our featured speaker tonight, Mayor Beth VanDuyne, Mayor Pro Tem Gerald Ferris, Deputy Mayor Pro Tem Tom Spink, Councilmember Oscar Ward, Councilmember Brad Lamorges, Councilmember Dennis Webb, Councilmember John Danish, and Councilmember Alan Meager. Mayor, we do have a quorum. From the City of Irving, we have our City Manager Chris Hillman, Deputy City Manager Michael Morrison, Assistant City Manager Romero Lopez, Assistant City Manager Max DuPont, City Attorney Charles Anderson, our Fire Chief Victor Conley, and our Chief of Police Larry Boyd. From the Irving Visitors and Irving Convention and Visitors Bureau and our partners, we have the Chairman, newly elected David Cole, and the Executive Director Mara Gast. From the Irving Municipal Court, we have Judge Laura Anderson. From the Irving ISD, our Superintendent, Dr. Jose Parva. And from the Irving Board of Trustees, our President, Larry Stipes, Vice President, Randy Randall, Board Member, Neil Ann Hunt, and Board Member, Randy Necessary. Please applaud, a round of applause for these dedicated individuals. This evening,
Please join me in thanking our presenting sponsor, Ace Cash Express, and welcome to the stage the Senior Vice President of Public Affairs, Eric Northrington. Eric?
I'm ready.
There you are. Thank you, Eric.
Thank you, Eric. Thanks so much. Good evening, everyone. Thank you very much. I'm very proud to be here tonight representing Ace Cash Express. You know, Ace is a 25-year member of the Irving Las Colinas business community. Over 500 of our associates come to our Irving office every workday just down the street here off MacArthur. We are always proud to be able to sponsor events with the best Chamber of Commerce that I know of, the Greater Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce. It's always an honor to work with a professional group like that. You know, at ACE, we believe that service to the communities where we live and work is a value that every business should embrace. Tonight, I want to share a few highlights of some of the ways that Ace Cash Express makes a difference in the hundreds of communities we serve across the country, and most especially here in North Texas and in Irving. So let's watch a brief video now. Thank you, and enjoy your evening.
In 2004, Ace Cash Express created the Ace Community Fund as a way to give back to the communities where we have stores.
Pizza.
Over the past 9 years, Ace has donated more than $7.3 million to worthy organizations that benefit children, education, and financial literacy.
Ace got me a book.
I think it's a wonderful thing that everyone came out, volunteered to help me with my new home. I would love to thank everyone from ACE.
In addition to the dollars we have raised and donated, ACE associates have volunteered hundreds of hours to worthy organizations like Back on My Feet. For the past 2 years, ACE has proudly served as the Back on My Feet financial literacy sponsor. ACE volunteers teach the ACE-created paycheck and banking basics and budget and credit basics financial literacy curriculum to Back on My Feet residents.
It's part of our community commitment here at ACE. I've always wanted to give back, and this is my way of giving back. And if I can reach one out of the many that we speak to, then I've done my job.
Let me just get out of the situation I'm in and do something different. You know, I didn't know exactly what I needed to do, but I know I need to do something different. I have a savings now. I got a good job. So I know how to save my money. You know, I got money in the credit union, and I got money in the bank, so I listened, I took heed, so, and it worked.
At Ace Cash Express, community commitment is an integral part of our corporate culture, and the results prove that our associates have a passion for giving back to the community.
Well, thank you, Eric. And Ace Cash Express, really appreciate that. One elected official that I neglected to recognize, and I regret that, and please accept my apology, Dr. Elba Garcia, our Dallas County Commissioner. Don't hold it against me, Commissioner Garcia. Thank you. I'd also like to recognize the platinum sponsors, Avial, our gold sponsor, Flowserve, our silver sponsors, Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, HMS, Holt Catt, the Dallas Business Journal, Property Advisors Realty, Reliant, that is an NRG company, Trendmeco, and many of our other supporting sponsors that are noted in your program. Also, I'd like to recognize my company, Kroger, who provided the table centerpieces for you tonight, and especially thank our floral staff at our North MacArthur store. Also, I'd like to recognize the Westin, and what a great meal they provided for us tonight in a terrific setting. Jeremy Berlin, Jocelyn Ambrose, and for their support of the state of the city. So let's have a nice round of applause for the Westin. Thank you so much. I would like to encourage your support of these great businesses and organizations, because without their generous support, we could not make this event possible and also do the work that our chamber does each and every day. I'd also like to thank the award-winning staff of the City of Irving for their hard work and their tireless commitment to improving our city. So if you are with the City of Irving, just please raise your hand, and I'd like to have a round of applause for our City of Irving staff. Another group that I'm extremely proud of that I get to work with, and that is the staff of the Greater Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce, the only five-star chamber in the state of Texas. So if you're with the Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce, please raise your hand. I'd like to recognize you. Also, Ashley Dixon, who's over there behind a monitor somewhere, she helped organize the whole event. So Ashley, wherever you are, thank you so much. Just a couple of other things I'd like to bring to your attention. On Wednesday, February the 25th, the Irving Chamber, in partnership with the City of Irving, will host Irving Day in Austin. This is a program that allows business leaders like yourselves to meet with our elected officials, tour the Capitol. And I invite each of you to join our president and CEO, Beth Bowman, our city manager, Chris Hillman, our mayor and members of city council to join us in Austin for a day. And you can find out more information on the back of the program about Irving Day in Austin. Also this evening, we're announcing the kickoff of the 2015 Best in Irving Award nominations. The Best in Irving is a celebration of the accomplishments and achievements of Irving's best businesses and many volunteers who lead the dynamic, progressive business community that we call Irving. Please follow the directions on the back of your program. Make sure that you vote for your favorite business to recognize their great work and their terrific customer service. I would note that Kroger is nominated a couple of times, so. As President Johnson said, vote early and vote often. I know you've already begun your meal, and I'm thankful for that. So please continue to enjoy your meal with your friends, make some new friends, have some great conversations, and we'll be back shortly with the presentation. Thank you so much.
We have around 700 employees in 7 different buildings across the Metroplex. Now we're all together here.
It was a major win for the City of Irving, and we are so happy to have you here.
They see us as a partner.
That's going to be fantastic. You know, we're already seeing a lot of impact.
Bringing 7-Eleven with that power and name is just a wonderful thing.
This is an attraction that's going to bring people from all around North Texas, even the country, into Irving.
You being here tonight proves the site, proves that we need entertainment in this location, that it will be successful.
We are getting a Whole Foods in Irving, Texas.
You've got really, really strong demographics here, a really strong daytime population with high wage earners. We think we'll have a really, really complimentary mix.
Yes, I'm very excited.
This is a big deal, being able to take light rail, commuter rail, into DFW Airport.
And that's what this is, a gateway to the world, an international opportunity to take mass transit to anywhere you want to go.
Oh, it's huge. First 5 stops out of the airport are in Irving, at the convention center. Stop in the urban center, tremendous for our hotels, for our conventioneers.
A true milestone day in the history of the 40 years of the airport.
It's like a small town.
This is what everybody comes for. This is the Airbus experience.
It's a massive economic impact. These flights are worth $200 million annually in economic value just to the greater Dallas-Fort Worth region.
It's been a long wait, and we're finally going to see some dirt moving.
We've always been a little hard to reach sometimes out here in this part of town, so this is going to be a very, very important improvement to our area.
We are so excited that we did this.
Oh, it looks great.
Terrific. It's going to be a boost for Irving.
We're going to wake downtown Irving up. I mean, you know, they're going to have to quit rolling the sidewalks up at 5 o'clock.
Irving's a great location because it's so vibrant. There's so many things going on. Lots of new development in the area, both in residential and retail. So it's a really exciting area.
We really like to be a part of the community. And the Irving Las Colinas Chamber has really helped us and welcomed us in. So we're very proud to be here.
You're getting high value development, single family homes, which is what our residents want to see more of. And it's really a win for Irving.
Right now, selling houses in Irving has never been easier. We just can't keep listings in our portfolio. Everything that we list sells almost immediately.
The city's working in partnership with the Heinz Development Corporation to bring up new homes. And the neat thing about these homes is this will be our first community downtown.
Being in the center of the country and the logistics area here, DFW Airport, the talent in this area of the country is a key contributor to our reason for being here.
Great city. We've had a lot of people come out and actually welcome us. It's been a great feeling.
We're excited about the new jobs that they're going to bring here. We're excited about the renovations to the space.
There you go. Keep going, jab.
I'm glad we did it in Irving. I love the city of Irving. I don't plan to go anywhere.
We're almost done. No, just kidding. We're not done yet.
And we thank you for everything you've done and look forward to the continued relationship that we have with the City of Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce.
The City of Irving, the center of North Texas.
We took a pin and dropped it in the dead center of the 7 million population of the Dallas, Fort Worth metro area. It's here.
In the middle of what's happening right now, from trains.
We are really a world player now.
To planes.
This is a very special and historic moment for Qantas.
To automobiles. Irving is a city in motion. The dark orange line now takes you all the way to DFW Airport, a perfect addition for a city named one of the top 50 meeting destinations in the United States. Irving is a safe city. Thanks to the Irving Police Department, Irving has had a record low crime rate for 10 years in a row. In case of an emergency or fire, the Irving Fire Department will respond in less than 5 minutes. That's better than the national average. Irving is an exciting city.
This is an attraction that's going to bring people from all around North Texas, even the country.
With a new entertainment center well underway, Irving is morphing into a destination capital of North Texas. Canal Fest brought in record numbers of people.
It's great.
The Main Street event expanded to include more music and fun. And Irving hosted the first ever Laughs by the Lake with big name comedians.
Maybe Tooth Fairy had a lot going on yesterday. Did you ever think about that? Maybe she had a really rough day and needed to unwind with a glass of Chardonnay.
The Chipotle Cultivate Festival showcased classic cuisine and concerts.
We love it. We're very excited.
Nice day and fun festival to be part of.
And next year is expected to bring even more events to this bustling city. Irving is a city of change. Right now, there are more than $163.2 million in capital improvement projects underway. These include streets, water and wastewater projects, and a library.
Beautiful. It really is.
Well, I think it's gorgeous. I think it's what Irving deserves.
There have been major improvements made to the busiest streets in the city, including O'Connor and MacArthur Boulevards.
The good news is that we should have, I think except for maybe one short section down south, we'll have all the overhead crossings done and underground, which really clears up, makes the roadway look a lot nicer.
And residents were given a taste of what downtown Irving will one day look like.
This is a 6-foot wide proposed bike lane, about 11 foot wide sidewalk, and then we have a transition zone here where we have, you know, the street trees and other vegetation, and then you have your parallel parking lane.
Irving is a booming city. This year, Irving added more than 6,100 jobs and secured big name businesses such as 7-Eleven, Whole Foods, and Envoy.
We have a lot of development going on in our city. We can't wait for you all to be able to experience it.
The HB Byron Nelson and North Texas LPGA shootout brought in crowds from across the country. From jobs, to economic growth, to transportation, to exciting events and entertainment, Irving is proving it is a city in motion.
Well, thank you. Hope everybody is enjoying their meal and the two great videos that we've had on economic development. Now it's my distinct honor and pleasure tonight to introduce our featured speaker this evening, the Honorable Beth VanDuyne. Mayor VanDuyne was first elected mayor of the city of Irving in 2011, having served on city council from 2004 until 2010. She was reelected for another term this past spring. Mayor VanDuyne is a 25-year resident of Irving, and the mayor has a keen understanding of the major issues and opportunities facing our city today. She is a staunch advocate for Irving on the national and international scene and is actively involved with the U.S. Conference of Mayors, the National League of Cities, the Texas Municipal League, and the North Central Council of Governments. She is committed to bringing new businesses and jobs to our city that will help expand our tax base and support new residential developments that would be providing expanded housing options to meet our residents' needs, and also the new companies that will be relocating or expanding in the city of Irving. Our mayor is also focused on the quality of life initiatives related to education, clean and safe neighborhoods, and recreation, and of course, our entertainment district. She is a strong proponent of open and collaborative government. In addition to a 20-year career working with small business startup companies, she worked with mid-sized private companies and Fortune 500 corporations. She is a dedicated volunteer. She's an involved homeowner, a devoted mother of two terrific kids, Katie and Pierce. As chairman of the Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce, I've had the opportunity to work closely with Mayor VanDuyne, and I can tell you there is no bigger supporter of our city's growth and economic vitality than the mayor. I'm looking forward to the mayor sharing with you tonight some of the major accomplishments from our past year and her thoughts on what's ahead, what lies in the future for our great city. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to our podium, the Honorable Mayor VanDuyne and a good friend.
So between the invocation by Judge Kincaid and that introduction, I think we could probably all go home now. That's it, really? I was thinking, yes! I'm kidding. We do have a lot of really good things to go over tonight. I want to welcome all of you to the Irving State of the City for 2015, talking about and recapping our 2014. This is my fourth time presenting, so you figure I should be old hat by this. But thank you, Susan Rose, for kind of holding my hand through this. And Karen Berlin, where's Karen? I know Karen is out here. They've been fantastic, and our entire communications team in putting all this together. And we're really pleased to be here tonight. I know some people asked why we weren't at the convention center. And part of the reason why we weren't at the convention center is we only had two nights this month that we could do it, and it's a good thing they were booked. So we came here instead, and this gets to highlight the $1.6 million upgrade from the Westin DFW. So, you know, when you have events in the future, you will remember to come to the Westin. It's always a good thing. So when discussing themes for this year's address, we looked back on all of the events in 2014, and they centered around a common theme. With all the new development underway, new policies to strengthen our city, and the launch of the Orange Line to DFW Airport, and expanding opportunities for living and working in Irving, the phrase people-focused progress best capture the moment in positive developments we're seeing. And what do I mean by people-focused progress? There's a slide, and there's a quote from Ronald Reagan that I think helps best define this. We represent the forgotten American, the simple soul who goes to work, bucks for a raise, takes out insurance, pays for his kids' schooling, contributes to his church and charity, and knows there just ain't no such thing as a free lunch. When I first ran for mayor of Irving, it was with this in mind. Leadership decisions made by our city must always have the people's needs, goals, hopes, and aspirations as our principal guiding agenda. And in this past year, we have made great strides in working to achieve this mission. We do not pass policy or budgets for the sake of getting the work done. We don't encourage new businesses to relocate here for the joy of the press release. And we don't expand infrastructure for for the pleasure of looking at a new building, road, or park. We do these things because they create opportunity. They create a means of improving the lives of our families and citizens, and we do these things because, above all, our citizens matter, and it's our responsibility to them, their families, and their future. When we achieve goals based around people, that is when we know that we have truly served. Before we go too far in reviewing our past success and future opportunities, I'd like for us to take a moment and remember and honor those that we lost in 2014. These folks were not just residents. They were part of the fabric of our community. They were leaders that inspired and motivated, and they did this by their service. They were mothers, fathers, brothers, and sisters. They were board members, committee members, and community volunteers. They were people of faith, and they believed in our city. We actually had one of our staff members, our city secretary, Shanae Jennings, whose father passed away last night. He's not on this, but we do want to make sure that we have her in our prayers today. And I also want to do a special call out to James Baker. For those of you who came to council meetings, you remember James was always in the back with a smile on his face. And we're definitely going to miss him at our council meetings. If you please join me in a moment of silence in their memories. Thank you. 2014 was a year of change and growth for Irving, particularly in some key leadership positions. And I'm going to ask you to stand when I call your name. Our city council welcomed Oscar Ward to its ranks with his election to place 5. We welcomed a new Irving ISD superintendent, Dr. Jose Parra. Irving appointed Victor Connolly as its new fire chief. And Coppell ISD appointed a new superintendent, Mike Waldrop. We were also pleased to see the appointment of Beth Bowman as the new president and CEO of the Greater Las Colinas, Irving Las Colinas Chamber of Commerce, our host this evening. And after many interviews and public dialogue and concentrated effort, we finally hired a new city manager. Chris Hillman, he joined the city last August from Surprise, Arizona, and in just under 6 months, he's already begun to make a mark on this city, and I think it's a pretty fair statement to say you haven't been bored yet. Seeing the diverse needs and changing landscape, and Chris, you need to stand up so that everybody can relate a face to a name. You've done a great job. And by the way, Chris came in 2 days or 4 days before our budget? 4 days. And did a great job of defending a budget that you didn't have to put together, by the way. Serving the diverse needs and changing landscape of Irving can be a challenge. It's a challenge for our council and staff, but it's a duty that we all signed up to take on. And just like any major organization, the needs always outpace the resources. We do disagree and we do debate at times, but these debates are productive and necessary as we represent a city of 235,000 people and 9,000 businesses. And sometimes it's all about communicating and defining our perspectives. Your city council endeavors every week to find solutions, create new avenues for growth, and conduct the business of Irving in an open, honest, and forthright manner. I want to personally thank and recognize the hard work of each of our council members. They put their entire time, you have no idea how much time that we spend in meetings and on the phone, talking to not only each other, but also talking to staff members, residents, and businesses. And they all have a role in helping to guide the city of Irving forward. And most of you know the work they do for the city, but I'd like to share with you some of their many contributions outside of their city role. And again, I'm gonna ask you to stand as I say your name. There's Mayor Pro Tem Gerald Ferris. And Karen knew I was going to call you first because she started laughing. And there's no stronger advocate for the Irving ISDs than Gerald, who also enjoys bike riding with his wife, Karen. And for all of you who see them on the trails and at parades, stop by and just don't throw lollipops at them. And he knows what I'm talking about because I got one right here at a parade. Wish him luck, too, because his daughter just started her freshman year at Texas A&M. Then there's Deputy Mayor Pro Tem Tom Spink. And with Tom Spink, it is all about his dogs and his wife. And he's been very passionate about the new dog training center at Baylor Irving Coppell, which will train dogs for use by disabled veterans and a cause that is close to Judge Kincaid's heart as well. Then there's Councilman John Danish. Everyone knows John for his incredible leadership role in DART. And if you did not know, he will remind you at nearly every meeting. But he's also very engaged at the Irving's Veterans Memorial Park. Thank you very much, John. Then there's Councilman Alan Meager. And Alan Meager keeps busy with his son, Connor, and is passionate about YMCA. You can stand up, Alan. He's passionate about YMCA, Irving Cares, and Keep Irving Beautiful. Then there's Councilman Dennis Webb. Dennis has a love in his heart for his church and foreign missions and taking his ministry to other countries in need. And Dennis also loves to pour rain sometimes on my parade as well as on me. I want you to look very closely at the expression on Dennis Webb's face in this slide. That was a cold day. And then there's Councilman Joe Putnam. Joe has always worked hard to preserve Irving's heritage, and no surprise, considering that his wife, Jan Hart, was the city's senior archivist. Then Councilman Oscar Ward. Oscar is active in Irving Ambucks, the number one Ambucks in the USA. The group has fed the homeless at the Irving Cares facility for the last 2 years, serving over 400 meals. And Oscar also seems to have multiplied himself, because I don't think there's an event since you've been elected that you've missed. So you need to share that secret with the rest of us. And then finally, there's Councilman Brad Lamorges. He is our transportation guru on the council, and it's only fitting that Brad likes to keep himself moving, because apparently he's an avid runner. And what did you just run? Didn't you just run a half marathon? Congratulations. And he's also a huge, huge, strong advocate of the Boy Scouts of America with his son as well. The high-performing team at the city also deserves a great deal of credit, and I'd like to ask all the city staff here this evening to please stand. I can see you guys. Stand up. Give them all a round of applause. Thank you. So the State of the City Address has played an important role in highlighting ongoing efforts and accomplishments achieved by our city, our business community, and by our citizens who prove every day that their loyalty to our community by living with us and by growing with us. It's an opportunity to emphasize some of the major issues and challenges we faced in the last year. And with new developments, new construction north and south, new companies choosing to make Irving their home, and new residents selecting Irving as a location to settle their families, it's a great time to talk about the future and what we see in the next coming months. Irving is not only on the move, and no, I'm not talking about earthquake jokes just yet, but it's also on the map, and we are making great strides, you knew I had to say it, in every aspect of our city, and the rest of the world is taking notice. What is most unique and compelling about Irving is that it has a very strong, diverse, and balanced portfolio, a vibrant blend of businesses, quality of life initiatives, excellence in education and in the workforce, expanded housing options, and an ever-increasing infrastructure. In tonight's address, I want to focus on three main aspects of our work and how they have served our goal of people-focused progress. We've got enhanced services and opportunities for residents, the economic development wins throughout the last year and prospects in 2015, and our numerous initiatives related to restorative infrastructure, or as staff likes to call pain before gain. And speaking of restorative infrastructure, you knew it had to come. As you're well aware, the Earth has recently chosen to remodel on its own. And although small and medium-sized tremors are not new to the North Texas region, they have provided a significant jolt, both literally and figuratively, to our community. And together with the Mayor of Dallas, we've convened a task force and retained specialists to help us determine the potential causes and courses of action. And while I am admittedly making light and making a little bit of fun of the tremors, I want everyone here to know that we are taking this seriously. We have reached out to federal and state, and we actually have a meeting with Governor Greg Abbott next Friday and our local partners to help us better understand the nature of these tremors, to ensure our emergency management personnel are prepared and are well coordinated, and provide as much information as possible to the citizens of Irving so that they can make informed decisions and preparations during this odd turn of geology. I want to thank our newly elected state representatives, Rodney Anderson and Matt Rinaldi, and Dallas County Commissioner Elba Garcia for their support and partnership as well. And now, some of the highlights of this past year. The region hosted the NCAA championship game. Any Duck fans? Oh, we got one over the two over there. The Cowboys finally made it into the playoffs. And I'm sorry, you can say what you will, but Dez did make that catch. That was a catch. We had a dog that ran for mayor. And no, I don't mean me, no matter what some of you may say behind my back. And then we do not have the mayor of Frisco. He's not here yet, is he? Mayor Mosso from Frisco is going to be here. And Mayor Mosso and I are really, really good friends. And he taught me how to shoot this year. And though I might not look like I know what I'm doing, that shot in the neck, that was mine. And yes, there were earthquakes. But during the last several months, I've had a greater understanding of some words and phrases and what they mean in terms of geology. Aftershock. An aftershock is a small tremor that occurs after the main shock and is not to be confused with a look on my face after a number of executive sessions. Swarms. If only swarms were a term to refer to a mass of bees, but no. We've now learned that swarms also apply to clusters of tremors occurring in a short period of time. P waves. P waves are the faster waves of earth movement that shake the ground and what make you first feel the tremor. And until recently, I thought P waves were just the yellow tinge ripples we all try to avoid at water parks. And of course, in this age of technology, apps continue to dominate. Wow, that was the funniest one. Apps continue to dominate our lives. And I just signed up for Did You Feel It? And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you haven't downloaded it yet. But in terms of keeping a people-focused progress agenda and the top of our minds, in all seriousness, we had a number of successes on behalf of the citizens of Irving. Lowering the tax rate was a major victory. Yes. We had made a pledge in previous years to residents and businesses, our loyal customers, that when the time came, we would put dollars back in their pockets. By lowering the rate, we are now the second lowest property tax rate in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. And this tax rate cut wasn't just a symbolic gesture. It was a statement from our city to the citizens of Irving that we believe in you just as much as you believe in us. And our citizens deserved this cut. It's also important to note the benefit to our corporate taxpayers. Just yesterday, I received this email. Quote, Mayor, this afternoon, we are notifying our employees that we have executed a lease for our U.S. headquarters in Irving. We looked at a number of markets across the U.S., and all indicators kept pointing to Irving. I know you took some heat for lowering the tax rate this year, but from a business perspective, it was one more reason to stay put. And that was written by Carter Holston from NEC Corporation. Irving's revenue stream continued to perform very well. Sales tax were up in fiscal year 13-14, increasing by nearly 11% to $58 million. And at the same time, property values rose by 6.7% to just under $19.3 billion. Both of these are key indicators, and they bode very well for our community. We took on several new initiatives, including passing of an ethics policy that provides increased transparency and accountability to our residents and our businesses. As we started on the process of updating our city's comprehensive plan, we'll begin this year development of both a long-term financial and economic development plan. All of you in this room need to be part of these processes. This is your city. We want to know from business leaders, residents, and even visitors alike, what do you want to see your city look like in 15 to 20 years from now? What are your priorities? And what vision would you like to see city leadership follow? Quality of life for Irving residents and businesses is always a key focus to the City Council, and we made substantial progress this year in the areas of transportation, safety, health, education, and housing. These are critically important to site selection specialists and CEOs looking to relocate to or expand in Irving, and we have many new initiatives and accomplishments to celebrate. In August, we officially opened DART's Orange Line to the airport. This segment now provides direct and easy access for Irving residents, businesses, guests, and students. This project has been in the work literally for decades, and I want to thank Irving's past representatives on the DART board, including former Mayor Dan Matkin, Norma Stanton, John Danish, and our current representative and former City Council member Rick Stouffer, for striving to make this critical connectivity a reality for our community. Our police department, under Chief Larry Boyd's leadership, continues to protect and serve at the highest level. We have maintained the lowest crime rate on record for 10 consecutive years. Our fire department, under Chief Conley, continue to excel as well, saving 97% of the community's property that were involved in structural fires. The approximate value of the property saved was about $237 million. Irving hospitals and their staffs worked to ensure we remain on the cutting edge of technology. Los Angeles Medical Center completed a $1 million renovation of its cardiac cath lab, part of its top-level cardiac services. And Baylor Irving began the renovation and expansion of its emergency department. Our pipeline of highly skilled future workers continue to expand under a strong educational system that starts with our independent school districts. Irving ISD recently received top honors as the best mid-sized district at growing enrollment and success rates in advanced placement classes. Why is this so important? Definitely clap for that. And why is that so important? Success in AP classes is directly correlated with success in college and beyond. So if our students are better prepared early on, they have bright futures ahead of them. Our charter schools continue to draw national acclaim. Uplift Education's North Hills Preparatory was named the second most challenging high school in America. And my kids both go there, I can personally attest to this. In fact, my son asked how long I was gonna go because he has homework tonight. Northlake College named a new president, Krista Sledgo, who is here with us tonight. Is Krista here? She doesn't want to stand up. Krista's way in the back. The college received national recognition by Military Times and GI Jobs for its outreach and support of our active duty personnel and veterans. And Northlake, which has 15,000 students, has also been recognized by the Aspen Institute as one of the top 150 colleges for student success in the country. Fantastic. At the University of Dallas, the accolades and positive growth continue as the university continues to make lists of national rankings with U.S. News and World Report, the Princeton Review, and Forbes, among many others. UD is now home to nearly 2,700 undergraduate, graduate, and doctoral students. And last year, the school broke ground at a new SB International Hall in its College of Business following an unprecedented $12 million donation from UD alumni, or UD alums Satish and Yasmin Gupta. So congratulations to the University of Dallas. Irving continues to offer one of the most diverse ranges of residential offerings, from apartments, townhomes, condominiums, to superior single-family homes. In recent years, the city, and I know you've heard me talk about this for every single state of the city, but I'm going to talk about it more because it's so important. The city has been focused on enhancing our single-family home offerings. And one look at the map of Irving shows all the progress. We've got more than 1,200 high-end homes in the Bridges at Las Colinas and Parkside East and West. We've got 60 more coming in the Enclave at Riverside Village, 130 more at the View over Las Colinas, and 120 in the new development underway in Valley Ranch. We're also hoping to fast-track new single-family homes in the Heritage development to draw more residents and businesses to the continually growing community in South Irving. In terms of creating new jobs and job opportunities and adding to our strong base of commercial clients, Irving once again had a banner year that will only serve to expand the desirability of living in our city and seeking to make your home among some of the best places to work in the United States. It is a tough task to select a few highlights in the year of great change and growth, and I'm really happy that Lucy Billingsley and her husband Henry are here tonight to talk about this as well. In April, 7-Eleven announced that they were relocating their corporate headquarters to the new Cypress Waters development at 635 and Beltline in Irving. And if you have not yet driven through this Billingsley development, I encourage you to do so. You'll find corporate office buildings, further retail offerings for our residents, and a beautiful new elementary school. Also in April, the city welcomed yet another new headquarters, Envoy Air, formerly American Eagle, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of American Eagle's group, and they relocated their headquarters to a new facility off of 635 in Irving. Grocery stores were a huge highlight in 2014. Kroger completed a $3.5 million renovation of its store on West Grauweiler in South Irving, expanding its grocery selections and adding new register lanes and energy-efficient upgrades. And just yesterday, we had a ribbon cutting of the new $13 million expansion of its store on North MacArthur Boulevard. They were able to purchase the former Barnes & Noble space and increase the footprint to more than 100,000 square feet. And by the way, this is a huge win-win. Kroger is able to purchase a large vacant retail space and turn a vacancy into new revenues for the city of Irving. And I know a lot of people were very upset when we lost Barnes & Noble and then Half Price bookstores closed. However, I was approached yesterday during the ribbon cutting by one of the real estate brokers who was very happy to announce that Half Price Bookstores is going to be opening in that shopping center. So we're very happy about that. So we're not done with grocery stores just yet. Did I hit that button by mistake? I was going to say drum roll, please. Because we shared the news in November of Irving's first Whole Foods market. Yeah, there you go. Which is now under construction at the corner of 161 and MacArthur. And this amenity has been on the top of the wish list of residents and businesses alike for a number of years. And I'm so happy that I can finally say that it's Whole Foods, because we've kind of sort of known for the last couple of years, but we were sworn to secrecy. So it is officially a Whole Foods, and we've already been there for the groundbreaking. We know it's happening, and we know it's coming. By the way, this development is also going to bring much needed new retail to the city of Irving, as well as create a new access point for the Las Colinas Medical Center. And finally, in what ultimately became a truly feel-good story, we saw the closing of one of our community's treasures, Big State Drug. Big State began as a haberdashery in the 1900s, before becoming a drugstore in 1948. And for the last 20 plus years, Brian and Stacy Smith have served this community not only through their outstanding pharmacy, which also doubled as a gathering place, but also through their volunteer work. News of Big State's closing in 2014 initially left fears of a tremendous hole in our community and on Main Street. But thanks to the vision of lifelong residents Rick and Susan Fearless, and I always call them Rick and Susan Fearless, we now have a new landmark, Big State Fountain Drug. And what a great win that is. My kids absolutely adore their shakes and ices, so when you go there, you gotta try them out. But that was a huge compliment to Main Street. So is Rick and Susan, are they here tonight? Anyway, if you haven't been down there, you need to check it out, because it's really, really a nice thing. In the realm of things to come, there's a lot of movement in both the commercial and residential sectors. Heinz has started work on several major single-family and townhome developments, including Parkside East and West, villas at the studios, and the new properties downtown. I cannot emphasize enough how important it is As we court large businesses, one of the first questions we're often asked is, how are your houses? How is your housing inventory, especially in this North Texas market now? These and other developments coming online are building Irving a robust selection of new high-end homes for executives and their families. You may have read about the Texas Center for Proton Therapy, which is under construction off of Royal Lane. The center will see its first patients in 2016, and it made big news last July with the arrival of the 200-ton cyclotron. And I'm not going to explain what that is. You don't want me to explain what that is. But this revolutionary technology will represent a major step in the fight against cancer in our community and beyond. If you've driven State Highway 114 lately, you've noticed all of the construction next to the convention center that will likely be home to the Irving Music Factory. We've finally broke ground on it. This is one of the most visible and talked about projects in Irving, and when completed, will bring additional entertainment options to our residents and our visitors. Looking ahead, one of the biggest opportunities that we have to date is the redevelopment of the former Texas Stadium site, and we have huge plans for it. We expect to have an announcement on the major progress on this site in the next few months. And if you haven't seen the initial site model that was developed by Oliver McMillan, I invite you to take a look at it in the lobby outside before you leave. And Oliver McMillan, just by the way, is a San Diego-based firm. I never thought I'd be really excited to say that we have a California-based firm coming in, but they're doing the construction and development on Texas stadium property. And when I called Dean Oliver and I said, Dean, I need to let you know we're having a couple of issues. I don't know if you've seen it in the paper or not, but we've had some earthquakes. And his response was, okay, well, what was the magnitude? And I said, well, we had that. This was on Tremor Tuesday. And I said, well, we had a 3.5 today and we had a 3.8 today. And he said, oh, honey, we call those minor tremors, not even a blip. We build hospitals on major fault lines. Don't even worry about it. So that, to me, made me feel a whole lot better moving forward on that development. Our convention center, and I should have included a picture that I took with Carl Urban. It was worth every dime of my $65 I paid for it. But our convention center has just finished its fourth year of operations. And since its opening, it's attracted more than 750,000 attending and more than 1,000 events. These events, from Comic-Con to ZestFest and the national sporting events, have helped put Irving on the national stage and captured the world's attention. I want to compliment Maura Gast and her entire staff for continuing to develop and deliver award-winning service in a nationally acclaimed venue that has attracted both international and national groups to the city of Irving. In 2014 was a truly phenomenal year in economic development, as you can just see by the numbers. And of course, we continued on a determined path of updating, reinvigorating, and expanding infrastructure development to better serve our communities, to ease transportation, and to respect our heritage. Indeed, infrastructure development was front and center in 2014. And I'm sure many of you have noticed while navigating through those lovely orange cones in the city. We have completed construction on projects totaling more than $36 million, and they include the brand new South Irving Library. We expended more than $20 million on critical infrastructure and also on facility improvements. Among our successes was the completion of the State Highway 114 expansion and corridor enhancement along O'Connor Road, including new green space. And at long last, we finally initiated substantial pre-construction work in anticipation of the airport freeway reconstruction project. No one is looking forward to the actual construction of 183, but remember my whole pain before gain? I promise you, when it is all said and done, if we are all patient and construction gets underway, it will be a vital step to our community as we continue to grow. There's also discussion of a new high-speed rail line that will connect DFW with Houston and other points in Texas. And Bill Meadows, who is heading up the high-speed rail planning group, is with us tonight. Bill, you want to wave? And Bill, as you might guess, there are folks here tonight that would just love that rail to be along the TRE line in Irving. I think you've got probably 10,000 reasons and businesses here today, but no pressure. A focus on history and historical significance continued to distinguish our community. From new historical designations on the Joffrey Gilbert House and the Ruth Payne Main House Museum, continue planning for the Heritage Museum and our new Texas Musicians Museum. We remain committed to celebrating our unique place in history. I admit, as mayor, I am somewhat biased when it comes to the successes and future potential in our community. But Irving is excelling and making the list in a very big way. Here are just a few of the lists that we've topped this past year. Irving was chosen as one of the top U.S. cities for millennials, best performing U.S. cities, third best cities for tech startups, one of the top 50 places to live, one of the top cities to start a career, safest cities in the U.S., and one of the best cities for jobs. I think that definitely needs a great round of applause. Our competition was fierce. And we also have, there we go. I should have done that before I asked for the applause, right? We also have received the Governor's Community Achievement Award and a Digital Cities Award for technology and have been recognized as one of the healthiest employers in North Texas, thanks to our strong health and wellness program. And I am so proud to report on the progress from last year. And I'm here to tell you that our city is strong, it's vibrant, and it's growing. In 2015, expect to see further economic growth as we attract global industry leaders to our community, an important factor for our city, which receives 73% of its tax base from the commercial sector. You're going to see the opening of new retail and the completion of new homes to meet the growing need for new housing, and a school system of prominent ISDs, private and charter schools, colleges and universities that continue to raise the bar on educational excellence. In the spirit of recognizing and celebrating the contributions of the innovators, leaders, and game changers that are in our community, I'm very proud to announce the inaugural Mayor's Award of Excellence this year. This award was conceived to recognize an Irving company, an organization or an individual that has a long history in our community, has been a strong leader among its peers, and is devoted to making the community or the region stronger and more vibrant. It is my hope that this award will be carried forward for years to come so that we might have the opportunity to thank those that are truly changing the city of Irving for the better. I am so pleased to be able to announce this year's winner. This company has been a member of the Irving business community for more than 95 years. A global leader in its industry, the company has more than 8,000 employees around the world, including more than 1,000 here locally. It's a family-owned business, but don't be fooled. This company has more than $1 billion in annual revenues and does business in 52 countries around the globe. But it's the company's local impact that's equally important. Companies refocused and targeted its charitable contributions to supporting Irving-based charities first. They are strong advocates for our public school system and are dedicated supporters of John R. Good Elementary School. Their annual golf tournament raised $20,000 for Good Elementary School trips and help funded iPads for students. They also volunteer in the classroom, mentoring students and encouraging kids to get interested in the sciences. They invest employee time and company resources in supporting Irving Cares by donating money, conducting food drives, and lending a helping hand at the food pantry. While they are innovators in business, it's also their service to others that should inspire us. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating NCH Corporation as the inaugural recipient of the Mayor's Award of Excellence. And I'm going to ask Walter Levy and his team to please join me on stage.
On behalf of our associates in Irving and all over the world, we really do appreciate this award. It's very, very kind of you. And you did such a good job. In fact, we have town hall meetings.
I want you to say these things. You do it better than we do. So next time we have a town hall meeting, you need to present. At lunch yesterday, I was with Bob Dalecki. He's the CFO of the University of Dallas. We butt up against, our campus goes against their campus, and so we were having lunch. And I said, I'm being honored, our company's being honored today at this meeting. He's here at the meeting. And I said, I've got a few words to say, and I've really worked on it. I think it's important, and I want to talk about it. He says, oh, let me warn you. He said, the University of Dallas got an award from another city, and he said, I had a speech, I was coming up, he said, I didn't even get to the stairs. 2 seconds, and then they said, okay, go away, here's your award, so you may not be able to speak. And so I said, oh, okay. He says, but if you do speak, could you please keep it short? So Bob, I'll keep it short, wherever you are. The one reason why we got this award is because our participation with the good elementary school. In fact, the principal is right here. And this, I would like to encourage all companies to participate with the school districts in this corporation school district mentoring program. I'm going to talk a little bit about it in a little details a little bit later. But first, I'd like to talk about education, if I may. I'm going to be a little wild. Y'all want to sit up? I hate to make them stand the whole time. You want to stand?
You're the boss.
Okay, all right, whatever. Whatever. Okay, so we all read and we all hear that the scores of some of our students are not as high as in other schools, and I mean in other schools in other countries. And we've all heard this. And where that fact may be true, that is only one measurement in the entire education system in America. I would argue that we have the best education system in the entire world. Part of that, if you go back in the 80s, how many here were out of high school in the 80s? Just by hands. Okay. Okay. Most of you, the others are going to have to Google this to make sure it's true. But the experts in the 80s said, the United States is on the downhill. The new countries that are going to lead the world is Japan and Europe. Well, 30 years later, we know that that's not true. So why were the experts wrong? I feel it's because of our education system. We have the best education system because we educate so many people, and that so many people help our companies be more productive, more innovative, and more imaginative. This year, there are 24 million people being in upper education today. 7 million in the junior college system, which is wonderful. We have 14 million in the four-year college system and 3 million in the postgraduate system. 24 million people are in higher education. Just think what's going to happen 5-10 years from now. It's going to be incredible. President Clinton said, in the 90s, he said to corporations directly, he says, times are changing. You all, corporations, need to help educate your staff, your workers, because we'll get left behind. And I know the corporations here, if we didn't do that, we wouldn't be here today. So we did that, and I'm sure all of you all did that too. President Bush said, no child gets left behind. And I interpret that as, we need to educate everybody. So in foreign countries, they really push these scores because they have a few seats at the college level where the high score people can go to. In this country, we try to educate everybody, and that's what makes us so productive now and in the future. Now I'd like to talk about Irving's vision. Irving has a vision of having corporations work with the school district, as we are doing with your school. This is fantastic. This is very, very meaningful. So I was thinking about this, why it's so important. It's very simple, and I encourage everybody, all companies, to do this. And if you have any questions, we have a lot of people here that are involved in this corporation, school district working together as a mentoring program. But why it's important is boils down to one word, and that's relevance. You all had a science fair. I know you call it something else, but in my day, it was called science fair. And we've all been to a science fair, probably by ourselves or with our children or both. And they're nice, but the difference in her science fair is that she brought NCH. She brought our chemist, just right here. She brought Christy. And she spoke of the relevance of chemistry and math, why it's so important, how we can make environmentally safe products to help companies save money and also reduce the dependency on water and fuel. And this makes education relevant. This is very simple. So I encourage all of you to participate in this program. I would also like to applaud the vision of Irving. It's mayor, it's city council, it's school board, it's school administration, and of course the chamber, for pulling this all together, this corporation and schools to work together, because this is a great vision that's going to pay dividends not only today, but 20 years from now. So please join me in applauding their vision. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, don't forget your
award. Oh, yes. Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you all. Thanks.
And I will make you a promise. If you can come and speak at my council meetings as passionately as you just did, I will easily come to any of your town hall meetings at your office. Because I think maybe it's just seeing different people, different voices, right? So we started the evening with a quote from Ronald Reagan, and I guess we ended one with Clinton. So we've been everywhere there and back. I don't know that there's a whole lot more to say, but I do want to thank you and your employees for the community and everything that you do and so many others. And you are truly an inspiration to us all. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, thank you so much for joining us tonight. May God bless our great city of Irving, our fantastic state of Texas, and the United States of America. Good night.